ladies and gentlemen. I'm John Gray, and we're just plain living here. This is the last day of spring.
Is it really?
Yes. Tonight it.
Tomorrow's the first day.
Sometime in the middle of the night, it turns
it
into summer.
I really think that might have happened yesterday. It felt like it. Oh, hi, I'm Peggy Burton.
And I'm Jim Fuller.
You sure?
And you're just plain living, not I'm just barely
you're
living.
You're just plain Peggy? They ain't nothing plain about Peggy.
Well, you know, I don't know about that.
That's right.
It's nice to be here and be alive.
We brought Peggy in, what, 10 years ago?
I don't know. I was
something
just passing
like that.
Through.
She was
like
just passing
stopped by to say hello.
She was filling in for John one day. Yeah. We just decided to keep her, so anyway.
Yeah, we needed a little credibility.
Yeah. John and I had been doing the show for about 15 years at that point, and our credibility was totally wasted.
How old is the show? When did y'all start it?
About
25 years ago. 25
something,
years
yeah.
ago.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, been doing it a long time.
So, that's why, from time to time, we apologize to our audience if we've told you this before, because, yeah. You know, after 25
can't
years,
always remember,
you kind of run out of stuff, yeah. You know.
Oh, but we've got some new stuff going on.
Yeah.
Shoot, we've got John conversations with John and Pat. You know, that's really kind of fun because that whole history thing that we
sure.
do started with Bob Couch when we were all supposed to, the world was going to self-destruct when the millennium came.
Right.
Everything was going to shut down and we wouldn't be able to get any money, no food, no anything. And so we started the millennium moment because we figured Bob Couch would remember all the history.
And he did.
And he did.
Phenomenal.
Of course, nothing happened on that New Year's Day.
I slept fine. I wasn't
and,
worried.
Bob did that for many years, and then Tommy Allen did it, and we've had different ones take a stab at it. But we're finally just really happy to have Pat Welch and John Rickman.
They do a great job of that. I hear a lot of comments.
Come on and do that. And I tell you what we're planning right now, folks. I want you folks to listen to this. Pretty soon, we don't have a date yet, but we're going to do like the big TVs do. We're going to have a John and Pat marathon. And one weekend, we're going to play. We've got over 50 episodes now. We're just going to play episode after episode after episode. Already have one sponsor for it. Clayton Shoes wants to be a sponsor. So if anybody else out there wants to be a sponsor for John and Pat, it'd be $100 and for that. And we'll promote it, and it'll be on the internet and everything. And you'll get to see Tullahoma and Chapel Hill. And what's kind of fun about it is John Rickman's from Chapel Hill, and they have us two and him, the Chapel Hill players, and so there's a little music involved, there's a little history from Chapel Hill and how a lot of that ties in with Tullahoma.
And they touch on the ghost stories,
ghosts and sports and Builder's Supply, of course, because Pat's father-in-law, the Sanders family, owned Builder's Supply, so there's a lot of those old tales from the lumber yard.
Right.
They have a lot of pictures, they go visit cemeteries, so it's really an interesting segment, and we're real proud to have John and Pat on our show.
Absolutely.
John always sings one of his songs he wrote or something you'll like.
Something that goes along with what they're getting ready to talk about that day most of the time.
They do a good job.
And you just got through with your grandson's graduation.
I know.
Austin.
It's so hard to believe. Yesterday
Where
he was in
that?
A box playing, and now he's graduating, going off to college. In Virginia.
Virginia, okay.
Yeah, he went to Fairfax High School, and huge class. But honestly, as far as graduations go, they moved them through really quick. It was like about an hour and a half. And I appreciated the fact that the band played, the chorus sang, and they did patriotic stuff. And when they mentioned all the kids that were going into the military, they got a standing ovation, and I thought that was neat.
Where's Austin going to school?
Oh, I wish you hadn't asked that. Newport something, and right now I can't think of the name of it. It's a fairly small college near Virginia Beach. I think that's what
near Virginia Beach.
I think that was the drawing.
Can you imagine being 18 years old, leaving home and going near Virginia Beach? How much fun this boy's going to have.
Oh, he has a good time. He has some great friends. I love being
there. I hope
we
learned something, but a lot of
we all do.
I remember when I graduated from high school, a lot of my friends went off to college, and that first semester kind of got them. There was too much party. And most of them actually went back and did really well. But it was rough, wasn't it, John?
Oh, yeah.
All of a sudden, you're away from home.
You can do anything you want to do. You know, Austin's had Peggy, who's a world traveler. Her father, General Burton, is a world traveler.
That's my son.
But that's his father.
Well, he was.
Right. His father is a general. So Austin is probably sort of a Renaissance man and has a little bit better insight on the world and living away.
He's lived in different countries
and
lived without a father.
By the way, Peggy, I think it was Bart posted a picture of your husband on the...
Ralph. When he was, he was 17 years old then?
Well, I just wanted you to know I can see why you'd been chasing Ralph.
He's a pretty man. I didn't know him then.
Yeah, right.
Because he was... Right. That's before me, but...
He was a great guy. He was... Ralph Burton was the calming force that undergirded the whole thing.
He was fun.
He was fun, but he was a very calming individual.
Most of the time. You weren't there when he jerked the TV out of the wall and threw it in the closet.
For real?
Probably deserved it.
Yeah, because I came home nagging and carrying on because nobody was doing anything but sitting around watching TV and I've been working all day. And I said, you're doing it, sitting here watching TV. Yeah, you know how women do. He just went quietly to the TV set, just took the whole thing, jerked it out, went to the closet and threw it in the closet, sat back down and said, is that okay now?
But it solved the problem, didn't it? Issue taken care of. I think that's great.
Yeah, he made me laugh a lot.
So how long before he put the TV back?
Oh, well, probably pretty soon. I don't know, a few days.
that situation, however you...
Did that ever happen at your house?
Of course. And the situation you describe is something that every man's been through probably at some point, you know. So.
Oh, well, he was a good one.
Yeah, old Bobby will probably find his way back home. If she'll wait till after the game, he'll find his way back home.
Right.
First down and 10, when she came walking in, said her sister's crying and all alone. I said, honey, I'm not to blame. If she wait till after the game, Bobby will probably find his way back home. And she said, that's just like a typical man, and I am one.
Yeah.
It's hard to know whether to love or to damn one. But, honey, there was a time you just had to be mine. Try to remember if you can, because the things that get under your skin are the same that way back then made you fall in love with a typical man.
That's cute.
Yeah,
did you just write that off the top of your head?
No, he just thought it up.
That was good, yeah.
He thought it up as we were sitting here this morning. So
I like it. I do. Yeah. I like it. Were you a typical man?
I am one. It's hard to know whether to love or to damn one.
Yeah, women need to realize that it's tougher being a guy than they realize, you know.
But the thing about it is, you see all these movies and these youngs and all of that, and most of the time the young girls go after the bad boys.
In
portrayed, you know, they want just that mystique of that bad guy.
They're more fun. Yeah.
Yeah, but then when they get him,
they want to change
all of that.
Forget that.
Yeah, you know.
It's not fair, really. It's not fair. Nobody should try to change anybody.
No. Yeah, and you know, I have to say that the young men today are much better than I was when I was that age. Right. And my son-in-law amazes me at the stuff he can do.
He's a nice guy.
And sometimes my daughter will fuss about this, and this, and I'm thinking, you don't realize how lucky you are. No, you should have seen me at that age.
Yeah. Walking through the bushes.
On
your way to Atlanta. Is this the way to Atlanta? In the middle of the night.
John is referring to an instance where he lived somewhere around Normandy.
Up on a hill.
And you really couldn't get there from here.
No.
You really had to want to go there because there was no There must have been a road somewhere. Did you walk through?
You had to go to Normandy and go to Normandy School and park your car in the field behind Normandy School.
That's how I got there.
Walk to the bridge that went over the river.
Yeah.
Go over the river and walk through blackberry bushes and rattlesnakes to that A-frame house. And we're over there one night, my brother and I, and here comes Fuller and Eddie Ray Finney. Coming, not only that, they didn't come that way, they'd come across the top of the hill. Briars, they was bleeding where the briars ate them all up. Y'all want to go to Atlanta? We're on our way.
Did you go?
No. Your wife know where you are? Well, that wife. Am I married?
That was many, many years ago.
Many years ago.
And there's two things that stick out to me. I can't believe I ever did that to begin with, but I was kind of like that at that stage in my life. However, I have this tremendous fear of snakes, and it never occurred to me that night that down there in Normandy, that place is full of rattlesnakes.
Oh, yeah.
I know.
You know, and it was pitch dark. You couldn't see anything, and here we are walking through those briars
to go
see our buddies, John and Jerry.
And Eddie Ray, probably nobody out there, very few remember Eddie Ray Finney, but he stopped when I was at UT. He stopped in there to see me one day. He was passing through, and I said, "Eddie Ray, what are you doing?" He said, "Oh, I'm just passing through." He said, "Let's go drink some beer at 10 o'clock in the morning." Okay. So we go. Well, Eddie Ray, when it comes time for him to leave, he don't want to leave. He said, "How about I just spend the night tonight?" He slept in my bathtub for a week and a half. Till he finally figured out he needed to get on down the road.
Eddie Ray is also the one who went missing for the entire weekend, or at least overnight, and told his wife at that time that we'd locked him in the cooler at the American Legion
by mistake,
and he didn't know he was in there, and we'd locked him in there, and he'd been in there all night about to freeze to death. His wife actually believed that story.
He would have frozen to death, wouldn't he?
Well, it wasn't a freezer, it was a cooler.
But just a cooler, okay.
Yeah, but...
Yeah. Well, the cone's up there, so that means we've gotten rid of the useless drivel. But it's been good useless drivel this morning.
Sure.
It's been fun useless drivel.
Yeah, that's right.
So what we're going to do is take a quick commercial break. Pay attention to our sponsors, folks. You know, without them, we wouldn't have been on the air for 25 years because we don't get grants or money given to us by anybody. It's the fine people who run the businesses in Tullahoma and this surrounding area who buy advertising on our channel. That's the only way we're here. And if you would go in their stores and tell them how much you appreciate them, and while you're in there, buy something. That'd help us all. We'll be right back.
The Russell Barnett Automotive family has launched its new Owner Advantage program. It starts as simple as your first year's maintenance is included with the purchase. We have 1 year, 3 year, 5 year plans available. Car detailing, car rental, collision repair. Stop by one of our 5 locations and let one of our certified sales staff tell you all about it. The Russell Barnett Automotive Family Advantage Program. And remember, my question is, why buy anywhere else?
All I have to do to think about what I was physically before and what I am now, and I don't ever want to go back to that original situation.
The overall mission of the rehab team is always what is best for the patient and how we can facilitate maximum potential from every resident.
Well, the most important thing to me is that I'm allowed to do whatever I want to do, you know.
Everyday Miracles, Life Care Center of Tullahoma.
Get your news first, fast, and free with your news leader on 6 every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday nights at 6, 8, and 10 p.m. Local weather, sports, community calendar events, and a comprehensive look at the latest news stories and newsmakers as only a video news broadcast can do. Get it first, fast, and free with News Leader on Channel 6, your local information network.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm pleased to have joining us on the set now Vicki Fulmer from the Senior Citizen Center. She is, by the way, the director of the Senior Citizen Center, which is, I'm not sure, I'm a little bit can't believe that she's not in trouble by now, because she brings all these seniors over there to the senior center, and I have an idea they're having too much fun. I'm not sure.
Well, we
are you trying to corrupt our senior citizens?
No, they can stay very busy on their own.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. Okay. You've got some exciting things coming up over there, I think.
We do. We've just finished our big celebration for our 45th birthday, and Thursday and Friday, the 22nd, 23rd, we have our health fair.
Mm-hmm.
Thursday is our screenings, and then Friday is just education.
Mm-hmm.
And our seniors, I think you find they do like to have fun, but they're very eager to be able to stay home, how to stay healthy, mm-hmm. those kind of things. So they're,
and I would imagine screenings and that sort of thing really help as far as preventive maintenance, if you will.
Absolutely.
To be able to do that.
Yes, and they're big with dance and exercise programs, and so, you know, we do the health screenings, and then we do an education the following day, and it's surprising to see how many come in for it,
mm-hmm.
particularly the education to sit and listen, you know, but it's great.
Yeah.
So,
and that's coming up when?
It's the 22nd, 23rd, Thursday and Friday. We start at 8 and we finish at 11 both days.
You know, you were talking about the education part of it. So what sort of things will they learn from this event?
We have the Kidney Foundation will be there, Marsha with Kidney Foundation.
Mm-hmm.
COPD will be there. We do have a hospice that will be there. Dr. Jerry Anderson will be doing a chiropractic screening, mm-hmm. and then some education. We have blood sugars, of course, the blood pressures, the routine stuff, but just a nice assortment of screenings.
When you talk about screenings, they'll actually sort of examine
yes,
you or
they
do
will.
In
yes.
whatever field that they might be in.
Yes.
I can imagine that could be very important for anybody, but particularly for seniors.
Yes, and we do things throughout the year, but this is kind of like our big little screening and education. But it's just so amazing to watch the folks that are genuinely interested.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're interested in their health and you know, that goal to stay home and continue driving and being able to go and come as they please, and it you know, it just all is like a puzzle, fits together.
I was kidding about you getting them into trouble, but honestly, you guys over there just do such a great job of getting people up and moving and thinking.
Yes.
A lot of it's mental as well.
It is, and we have lots of folks that come, you know, they may just be in for pool, or they may come in for exercise, or dance, line dance, or cards, but they come and go as they please. It's not unusual to see them start the day out with us, then go home,
mm-hmm.
and then be back later.
Mm-hmm.
So it's great. And then it's a very interesting group. Mm-hmm. Very interesting.
And I think you guys just started some sort of dance class, didn't you?
Yes.
What kind of dances
it's
are you
doing? It's a social
now?
Ballroom dance that
uh-huh,
Valerie
yeah.
And Dennis have started, and that's on Tuesday afternoons. Peggy's big participant in that,
mm-hmm.
and so it's going well. And then of course we have line dance that Peggy Lewis teaches, and then we have partner dance that Wanda Duke teaches,
yeah.
and then we have exercise throughout the week. And
so if you don't have a partner, will you find them one, or how does that work?
I think Wanda will work on that.
Yeah,
and then
okay.
the social dance does not require a partner.
I see.
So, but you know, the partner dance with Wanda, I probably don't need to answer that because I'm not sure how it works.
Okay.
But anyway, and then line dance, of course, you don't have to have a partner,
right.
but it's a great thing. So.
You see their number there on the screen, 455-2504. So I'm assuming that they can call that number to get more information
yes.
about any of those activities
yes.
if they'd like to.
And we have door prizes on Thursday and Friday. We have a big lunch on Thursday and a big lunch on Friday. So we just hope folks will come down and join us.
Okay. And if you really would like to find out more about any of those activities we're talking about, just give Vicki a call at the Senior Citizen Center, or I suppose anybody can probably
yes,
over there
absolutely.
can give you information about that and find out what you can do to get yourself out. The social aspect of it is probably as important as anything else.
Absolutely,
you know,
it really
so
is.
So that you don't just sit home by yourself. You
no,
get out there and
be
get
somewhere.
Involved in something.
Yes, be
exactly.
somewhere.
I guarantee you it'll be a lot of fun, folks, because Vicki is a fun, fun person,
well,
and that she's the instigator of a lot of these things that happen.
Well, thank you.
Vicki, thank you so much for coming
you.
By today. Folks, give them a call at 455-2504 and find out what's going on at your Senior Citizen Center in Tullahoma. They got lots of fun activities. You need to be a part of that. We'll be right back with more Living right after this.
Damn you.
Centers for Healing provides medical care to the working uninsured of Coffee, Franklin, and Moore counties. We are in Tullahoma from 8 to 5, Monday through Thursdays, and in Manchester on Fridays from 8 to 12. We provide primary medical care and offer an in-house disease management program.
My name is Rosie Mitchell, and I would just like to say I am blessed to have partners in my life.
Please call 455-5014 for more information. Thank you for being one of our Partners for Healing.
Hello, this is Janie Price. When my husband Ray Price would tour across the country, his favorite place to dine was Cracker Barrel Old Country Store locations. His favorite thing to order was the Uncle Herschel.
And the beauty of it all is forever, you'll be holding me too.
I miss Ray dearly, and I'm so proud that his last album, Beauty Is the Final Session, is available at his favorite restaurant.
A love affair to remember.
The project includes a duet with Martina McBride and harmony vocals from Vince Gill. Ray believed this to be the best recording he had ever made.
Oh, I wish I was 18. Again.
I think you'll agree when you pick up your copy of Beauty Is the Final Sessions at a Cracker Barrel Old Country Store location near you or at crackerbarrel.com.
A world without breast cancer is a world with more birthdays. And signing up for the Making Strides Against Breast Cancer Walk will help us get there faster. The American Cancer Society invests in groundbreaking breast cancer research, and we're part of every community. In fact, one in two women newly diagnosed with breast cancer turns to us for support. Sign up today at makingstrideswalk.org. Together, we can finish the fight against breast cancer.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're back. And last week, it was week before last, there was an event at the Templar Shooting Sports Gallery or range out on the Winchester Highway. It's right past the utility board on the left-hand side. And I remember when that went before the Board of Mayor and Aldermen about whether that would be a good thing to do or not to do. And they passed it, and it is wonderful. It is a beautiful facility. It's run by very professional people. And the NRA had an event out there, and we went and got a little video and then interviewed Rich, the owner. And just want you to see what's out there and what's available to you in this small town of Tullahoma. It's education about firearms, the possibility of purchasing firearms, and they're just really good people, really professional people. It's Templar Shooting Sports.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're at the Templar Indoor Shooting Range, and it's Templar Shooting Sports, and they're having an event today. It's an NRA event, and we're going to go in here and just see what's going on with all of these folks. Our buddy Claude Morris is part of this, and it's a big event. They're doing a good job. They're a new business here in Tullahoma, and we're going to find out what's going on here.
All right, folks, this place is full of people. There are people around everywhere doing things. And hi, how are you this morning? They've got every kind of gun you can imagine here. And people, this is a great event that's taking place here in Tullahoma. What they sell here is they sell guns. Hi, how are you? Good morning. You having a good day today? Good, wonderful.
A great day there, Craig. Right?
Looky here. There's Craig right there from Cat Country.
What's happening, man?
Everything's great, buddy. Good to see you.
Templar Shooting Sports, come on down.
There you go. They're giving things away here, and there's people everywhere. And there's 50 tickets, 20 friends of NRA Wall of Guns. There's Claude. Hey, how y'all doing? Good to see ya. Look at that face right there. I know that face. What are you doing today?
I'm here helping raise money for youth shooting sports and safety. A lot of this money will go to the Crockett County High School Trap Team. the Lynchburg 4-H trap team. We also make it available if they put a grant application into the ROTC air rifle teams at Coffee County and at Tullahoma High School.
Right.
And there's a trap team over in Shelbyville. We also hope to get the Eddie Eagle Gun Safety Program to local schools this year.
All right, this is Richard Brooks at Templar Shooting Sports, and we've been down today. They've had a great event down here. Richard, who's this lovely young lady here?
This is my daughter, Ruthie.
Ruthie. Hi, dear. How are you?
Good.
Good. Well, tell us a little bit about the business.
Well, we've got an indoor range, which obviously is the highlight of coming into our building. But we do have guns for sale. We can rent guns. People can walk in right off the street. We've got educational classes from if you've never touched a gun before in your life to we'll turn you into a ninja. So we've got advanced courses, the handgun permit course for the state of Tennessee, which is a very popular course, which is $75 a person or $125 for a couple, so we give couples discounts.
Oh, that's great.
We've got t-shirts, apparel, our own logo apparel. We've got Grunt Style and Nine Line clothing and t-shirts in here. I've even got my own brand of coffee that is roasted right here in Coffee County, four blocks away from us.
All right, that's great.
We got
man.
A little bit of everything going on.
And how long have you been in business here?
7 months now.
7 months. I remember when it came before the board of Mayor and Alderman, you know, right. about this shop and what was going to happen here. There was some discussion there, and I was very pleased when all of that went through for you the way it did.
It was a good day.
Yeah, it yeah. was a good day.
This is Remington.
That's Remington. Look at him. All right. All right. So this is a family business here.
It's a family business.
What are your business hours
business
here?
Business hours are 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. Monday through Saturday and 1 to 6 Sunday afternoons.
1 to 6 Sunday afternoon. And this is Saturday. And this is date afternoon.
This is date afternoon. Actually, we do a date night once a month, and that's on the fourth Saturday of the month. It'll start over again in September. I've put it on hold through the summertime.
Right, right.
So Friday nights through the summer, we're doing, Friday nights 5 to 8, 2-for-1 on the range. So bring your sweetheart in. And
that's great.
Range time for half price.
That's great. What's your address at this location?
1101 South Jackson Street.
Right.
And our phone number is 931-222-4657. You can find us on Facebook, Templar Shooting Sports, and our website is www.templarshootingsports.com.
What a great family right there.
Cheese.
There you go. Smile real big. I'm going to zero in right there on that young man right there. He's going to be on television.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the paint. I just knocked a tree over. This is the paint doctor. I got the color wheel. Now, you know what a color wheel is? It is the wheel at the paint works where you pick all your colors to paint your room. It could be a multicolored beard. It could be a underarm fan. You never can tell. One thing we do know is that it's time to paint. You know, you can make your wife very happy if you go to your house and paint some rooms, or you paint the outside of the house, the inside of the house. It makes them feel very good because you work hard for them, and they like that. All women like to see their man sweat, you know? They do. Honeydew is what they do. And you get to do it, too. So you go to the paintworks at 1960 North Washington Street, and you see Dabbit Eikonen over there, and he's the real paint doctor. He fix you up with color. It's so nice when the color is right. Go to Paintworks today, Martin Senor. See, Martin Senor, right there. Martin Senor out of the Paintworks. Bye, and we see you next time. I'm burning up.
You know what, guys? There's a lot of tree branches and dry brush over here. We should probably move the bonfire over there.
Thank you.
guessing Smokey liked that idea.
Cool off this summer at Tullahoma Splash Island. Fun for all ages. Free 25-foot slides, lazy river, fun water features for toddlers, tasty food items are available. All this and more, only $5 from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. or 4 p.m. to 9 p.m. Sundays, 1 to 5. Join the fun at Tullahoma Splash Island.
I am excited today to have with me Cliff Roberts from the Manchester Arts Center and Oldies.
That's
classic
right.
Oldies, Classic Country.
Country Show.
I think that's got to be a great show. Jason Petty is he kind of a headliner in there?
No, he's just one of the team. Yeah, it's the way it is.
Jason's a team player,
yes,
and I'm so proud
of him.
He's a
good fellow, really talented, and he does his Hank shows. You know, he's coming up with a Hank show in Woodbury pretty soon, I think. Yeah.
Good.
And he travels around everywhere doing that, even up into Canada.
Yeah. So. Your show opens this weekend.
Yes, Thursday night. Yeah.
And you go Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, matinee?
Right. We're doing 7 o'clock shows at night, and then Sunday afternoon is 2 o'clock.
And if we could get on the number, 931-570-4489, and the website, I'm sure getting tickets on the website.
That's a lot easier,
is a good idea.
MillenniumRep.org is the website, and you go on there and you can pick your seats.
I gave the wrong number. No, I didn't. That's right. I'm sorry.
That's right.
It looked different. I don't see that well. Anyway, how many is in the group now?
Oh, my goodness. It's just hard to. There's Jamie Harden, which is his show, and he does all the.
He does the directing and writing.
The headache stuff.
Yeah.
And then there's his wife, Becky Harden, and Carrie Kiridoff. Todd Green, Karen Wainwright, Annie Clements, Laurie Berger, of course, Jason Petty's with us, and the band, we've got new people in the band, Jesse Hanks, Jeff Haley, Susan Green, Jared Strike, Joe Miracle, and a special guest is fiddle player Mark Baczynski that plays with Jason Petty all the time, and
Where's he from? Maybe the Nashville
Cornersville,
area?
I think.
Yeah. It's always good to have a great fiddle player.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I mean, they can fill a lot of holes. What do your players play? They play guitar, bass, drums.
Yes, yeah, guitar. And Jesse Hanks, he's the bass player, and he plays an upright and an electric bass. And Jeff Haley, that's Becky Buller, which is Miss Bluegrass. That's her husband, and he plays flat-top guitar. And,
do you have a steel guitar in that group?
Don't have a steel. I wish we did.
Yeah. Well, you can't always find that.
Yeah.
I know. Steel guitars are hard to find.
Yeah.
But
I know a few players, but not that many. And, of course, we got a drummer and keyboards and another guitar player from some of the guys are from Murfreesboro and different places. So, yeah.
I know that you perform all around Middle Tennessee, and I'm excited to say that we're having your Elvis show at South Jackson Civic Center.
Oh, yeah.
This next spring, I believe. I'm not looking at dates. So.
Right,
but
right.
Anyway, we're excited about that.
Well,
love
I'm
your
excited.
Outfit. Does everybody have new outfits?
You have to look good.
You have to look good. You have to look classic country.
That's right. Yeah, yeah. There's some old stuff, you know, like George Jones, Waylon Jennings,
Merle Haggard,
yeah, and of course Conway Twitty. You got to have some Conway in there, yeah, and some Johnny Cash and some Jim Reeves and stuff.
And I guess some Hank.
Oh yes, of course.
Especially
Hank. You got Jason Petty.
Yeah.
He is Hank.
You know, I think that there's a lot of us that love the classic country.
Yes.
And because we've watched country music evolve into a whole different thing.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
And I enjoy when I watch a show that has country music, I enjoy seeing something where I can understand the words.
Yes.
I can
yes.
see their face without the flashing lights.
Oh, yes.
And so I think it's a unique idea. And a great idea to do a classic country show.
Yes, yeah. I mean, the modern country. It's like what Southern rock used to be.
Yeah.
I think it's kind of evolved more into that. That's just my opinion. But you know, most people that come to our shows, they remember this kind of this era of music better anyway.
What's your favorite? I know you do a lot of songs, and I know you do Elvis, and I know you do. Who is your favorite artist to emulate?
I don't know. I can do a pretty good Willie Nelson, so it's not.
And who doesn't love Willie?
Yeah.
I saw him in Atlanta one time, and he just, we were in this big place. I don't know that it was an auditorium. It was kind of like a gymnasium or a factory.
Oh, yeah.
But he just wandered in with his band, and they just kind of took their time. And I just love the way, I love the ambiance of the whole thing because it was relaxed and laid back, and it was great music.
Oh, yeah.
And he's been singing some big band music lately, I've heard.
And, of course, he's written a lot of songs for other artists also, you know, for Patsy Cline and people like that.
So you're singing Willie in this show?
Mm-hmm.
Do you wear the pigtails?
No, I can just let my hair down braided, I guess.
Just let it in. You can do that. Yeah. All right, this is coming up this weekend.
Yes.
Thursday night, Friday night, Saturday night, and Sunday matinee.
Right.
And after, and it starts at 7 o'clock,
yes.
And remember, that's how you get tickets. And honestly, I know your tickets sell out really fast.
They usually do. The Thursday night show would be one that you could more than likely get tickets for. I think the Saturday night show's pretty much sold out. I'm not sure about the rest of the shows. But if you go online, you can tell. It shows the theater and the seats, and you can pick your seats.
The beauty of that venue where you play is that there's not a bad seat in
there's
the house.
There's not.
Honestly, you can sit in the corner, you can sit in the middle. It doesn't matter where you are, and I think the sound is wonderful.
Mm,
it really is. Do y'all take a sound engineer with you when you travel?
Well, we usually depend on the venue.
Yeah.
It just depends. I bring my stuff into the over there in Manchester. Yeah. And
do you mind telling what tickets are? How much they
$20.
Are? $20, and that's for everybody?
Mm-hmm, yes.
And
And we do, and this is a fundraiser for the Arts Center in Manchester, too. So it helps them, and because, as well as I do, it takes a lot of money to run a facility like that.
Oh, yeah, I don't think anybody has any clue how much electricity is,
right.
Water bill.
You know, just normal utilities in a month's time over there is probably about $1,500.
At least.
Yes.
At least, and I think that's one of the biggest issues we all have. And y'all have plenty of sponsors for this show?
No.
No. They don't necessarily sponsor you. Mm-hmm. You're just going
there
and
do it. Yeah, we pretty much just do it on our own.
I guess Jamie Harden Signs.
Yes.
That company gives you a lot.
Yeah, and my company also.
This is beautiful advertising you have. Mm-hmm. I love the pictures of all the artists.
Yeah. Jamie, he does a really good job on putting it together and doing. He writes the shows too, so he's busy all the time.
He writes, he sings, he plays trumpet.
Yes.
He played trumpet for me one time.
Yes. And, he's actually playing in the Funny Girl that's coming up.
Is he?
Yeah, it's. And some of the people that are in our this show are actually in Funny Girl too. Yeah,
there's a great season over there, by the way. I have it on my wall at home. There's always something going on in Manchester and something going on in Tullahoma, unlike it was 30 years ago. Now you have no excuse to have to sit home on the couch. You need to get out and go see a show. And the part that I love the most is it's live.
Yes.
You don't have canned music.
Right.
It's live. You're doing it yourself. And I just love that. And I give you great accolades for putting this together.
Well,
how many shows do you have lined up for this next year?
Several? Oh, my gosh. I don't know. The rest of the year is pretty full, too.
I know. You go from one to the other.
Yes. We're in Crossville, and we're here, and we're there.
I know you're in McMinnville.
And, we're doing Christmas shows this year, which we didn't last year. We're doing a...
Well, we're going to have to go because they're cutting us off.
Uh-oh.
Good luck this weekend.
Thanks
for coming.
Thanks for having
me. It's always great to see you.
All right.
We'll be back.
The Animal Shelter has served Tullahoma dogs for nearly 30 years. Now, you can help us build a bigger and better no-kill shelter. Your tax-deductible gift is matched dollar for dollar. So come on, bark it forward and donate now to have your tax-deductible gift matched. make your check payable to the COT Shelter Building Fund, and go to tullahomatn.gov to see all the unique gifts available for your generosity. For more details, you can call City Hall at 455-2648.
Did you take your medicine?
Oh, gosh, I forgot it.
Her nurse.
You need a claim number?
Her personal assistant.
Can I just grab a...
Her housekeeper. Her cook. Her accountant. When I started taking care of Mom, I didn't realize the challenge of playing so many roles. But above all, I'm still her daughter.
Visit aarp.org/caregiving to connect with experts and other caregivers. Together, we can better care for ourselves and the ones we love.
Yeah, we had David Pennington on here a couple of weeks ago talking about the financial impact of Bonnaroo on our communities around here in the county and the cities and all the great things that are happening. It's a huge industry that probably infuses more money into our county and our towns in 4 days than most of the rest of the industries around here infuse in the whole year. But it's great fun for everybody, and our staff goes over every year. This is the 14th year of the P-Heads being at Bonnaroo, led by Philip P-Head Scoggins, and maybe Andrew's gotten back by now. We really don't know, but he'll surface sooner or later. Let's see a little bit of Bonnaroo.
We're here to receive the key to the city from the mayor.
Welcome to Manchester. On behalf of the city of Manchester, we're glad to present this. We call it the key to the city, but we give a good time. We think that's better. So, thank you very much, and we're going to present this. I want to give you this. Thank you. And I have the honor of making a presentation on behalf of the county. As county mayor, I would like to present you folks the key to Coffee County. Presented to Preservation Hall Jazz Band in recognition of your passion, your dedication, and outstanding contribution to jazz music fans around the world. So Bonnaroo 2017, the key to Coffee County, Tennessee, Gary Cordell, Mayor. It's an honor to have you here.
I'm speaking today with Adam, who is with Musical Intervention. And Adam, tell us about Musical Intervention.
Oh, wow. Thanks so much for coming to view it. Yeah. Hey, listen, we're out of New Haven, Connecticut. We're a music community program. So we offer the opportunity for folks who are homeless, at-risk youth, veterans, people in recovery, to write and record original music together and then connect and perform for the community at large. And what we're seeing is just people from all walks of life coming together in a very unique way.
Oh, wow, man. And I'll bet here at Bonnaroo, you've certainly been having a wide variety of folks coming in to jam, right?
That's been the most amazing thing to see. I mean, so many people have come here, they haven't played in a couple of years, and they've been re-inspired by music. You know, maybe they got something on their mind, and they're done playing, they're like, man, I needed that so bad.
Right.
So we're just really glad that Bonnaroo has allowed us to come in and give people the opportunity to explore the song inside.
And you know, you talked about helping veterans and homeless folks. That's got to feel really rewarding to know that you're reaching out and, you know, giving some help to some folks who could use an outlet.
Yeah, that's true. My father's a Vietnam vet, so I've been around vets most of my life. And, you know, I had a really great opportunity to work with an Afghan vet whose Humvee got blown up. He experienced some traumatic brain injury, and then he came home. His wife left him, and he wanted out, you know. Yeah. And so I was working with an organization that serves veterans, and they suggested that we connect. We ended up writing an incredible song called The Neverending Fight. And it's to help veterans understand that, you know, this is a continuous fight, you know, to keep their lives and you know, keep these guys alive. Yeah.
Well, is there a way folks can learn more about musical intervention or maybe even hear the song you were speaking about?
Absolutely. You can check it all out at www.musicalintervention.com. It's on YouTube. We got a really great YouTube channel, Musical Intervention Everything.
Wow. Well, Adam, again, you guys are doing such great stuff here, and I'm sure you're having a great time out here at Bonnaroo.
We're ready to get jamming in a few minutes.
There we go.
It's been amazing. It's really been amazing. And thanks so much for coming by.
Hey, man, we appreciate you talking to us, and keep up the great work, man.
You too.
I am here speaking with one of my favorite human beings at Bonnaroo, and that is Shaggy, the king of the crawfish king, who takes care of us with the crawfish boil every year. And oh my gosh, it's been how many years now, Shaggy?
I've been doing it for 14 years here at Bonnaroo. We drive up from New Orleans every year, and yeah, we make sure we're in guest hospitality here, so we're not in a general population of Bonnaroo. Guest hospitality is more or less for, you know, promoters, friends, comp tickets, vendors, families, you know, families of the band members, all kinds of, you know, it's where the cool people hang out. But anyways.
And even us. They even let us back here.
Right, exactly. This is where you're camped. That's awesome. You're in a great spot. I mean, we have all the trees and, yeah. I mean, this is key, you know. We come up here, and I've been doing it for 14 years. I work for Superfly Productions, which is, you know, pretty much the creators of Bonnaroo. And, you know, it's gone, over the years, it's kind of going different directions, and Live Nation owns it now or whatever. But, you know, we're still here, and we're still, you know, going strong. We drive up from New Orleans, Louisiana, and every Thursday, the first Thursday of Bonnaroo, we do a rather large, like, welcome to Bonnaroo and guest hospitality crawfish boil. And we, you know, we do anything from 500 to 1,000 pounds back there. And it's a free event. And it's just like everyone comes and has a good time. And a lot of people eat crawfish for the first time. And I like to say, and it's really a joke, but I am the last thing that happens at Bonnaroo.
Yes.
And after the headliner on Sunday night, post-headliner, in artist hospitality, I go on. So we do 1,000 pounds, and it's another free event that Superfly, you know, is more like a thank you. Instead of welcome, now it's
exactly.
Thank you.
Exactly.
Thanks for coming to our festival, and here's a crawfish boil and a lot of fun. And you know, a lot of the artists show up, and, you know, everyone's saying goodbye to each other, and they're eating crawfish. And
it's a good wind down.
Well, it's a good wind down, and it's also like and for me, it's the last thing they remember. You know, like, oh, yeah, I just saw the police, but I ate Shaggy's crawfish.
There you go.
Wow, that's awesome.
Thank you.
with Sean and Andrew, who are with Magic Hat, a fine, fine brew that is enjoyed by many out here at Bonnaroo. And Sean, if you would, tell us a little, tell our viewers about Magic Hat.
Well, we are a craft brewery from Burlington, Vermont, and we have been part of Bonnaroo for forever. And this year we're available all around the grounds in drafts and in cans and in the Brewfest. And we're super excited to talk to everybody and see some great music. And yeah, it's been a great, incredible weather, and we're super psyched.
Absolutely. Yeah. We couldn't have asked for better weather for Bonnaroo, right?
It's great. It's apparently, this is my first Bonnaroo, but we've been talking to people that have been to every Bonnaroo, and they say this is the best weather ever. So
how are you enjoying your first Bonnaroo?
It's amazing. It's great. It's a lot to take in. I'm not used to the crowds this big, but it's been amazing, and there's just so much to do everywhere. So.
Oh, it's something for everybody, right?
Exactly.
Manchester Funeral Home, we know the importance of living and working in our local community because it's those families who we serve during their time of need honorably. We believe in supporting local business and offer only 100% Batesville caskets, the best in the industry and a driver of our local economy. If you want straightforward and fair pricing while working with the people you know, choose Manchester Funeral Home, serving your community since 1932. And pre-planning and pre-funding can be the best gift you ever leave your loved ones. Call us to pre-arrange. Manchester Funeral Home. Our family, caring for your family since 1932.
If you want to be a parent, it doesn't matter how you play, what you wear, how you dance, or even what direction life takes you. You just need to be there. You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care don't need perfection. They just need you.
How long has it been since you raced a cheetah? Are your tornado creating skills getting rusty? Tired of being the only one in your neighborhood who hasn't built a dinosaur? Sounds like it's time to visit the Hands-On Science Center. The Hands-On Science Center is an indoor science playground. In this museum, please touch is the rule. Join us for weekly science demonstrations on space, lasers, lizards, rocks, and a whole lot more. No two visits are ever the same, so visit often to see our ever-changing exhibits and demonstrations. The Hands-On Science Center, 101 Mitchell Boulevard in Tullahoma.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, and we're pleased to have joining us now the community coordinator of the city of Tullahoma, Winston Brooks. And I haven't seen Winston in a while, so there's no telling what he might have been into. Winston is one of those who has knowledge of any subject you want to speak to him about. Usually we talk about the weather when he's on, and today is the last day of spring and the first day of summer.
That's a good point, Jim. It's great to be here again. Good to see you. Thanks for having me on. And tropical storm headed our way.
Really?
The good news is that it will be well out of the way before July 3rd, which is going to be the Tullahoma Kiwanis Club Independence Day regional celebration here in Tullahoma. And we are so excited to announce that we have Miller Lite, Southern Community Bank, and Budweiser presenting the Tullahoma Independence Day celebration this year, and it is going to be bigger and better than it was last year. Did you make it out last year?
I think I did, yeah.
Excellent. Well,
when you've been around as long as I have, you forget from year to year.
Well, you can remember, because last year was at the baseball stadium and Fraser McEwen Park,
mm-hmm.
and that's where all the action's going to be. We're going to have vendors, food, fun. We've got a kids zone. We've got main stage is going to be right in center field of the THS baseball stadium.
Mm-hmm.
We've got live music, world-class fireworks that are going to start around 9:15 as it gets dark, and then the gates are open this year at 3.
Mm-hmm.
So most of the time it's been in other locations, but if you can remember being in the baseball stadium for the fireworks, then you were there.
So this is kind of an event that's several hours long, so you, particularly if it starts
right
at 3 o'clock.
So the gates are going to open at 3. The first band will start at 3:30. It's a 70s and 80s band called Vinyl Radio. They're
mm-hmm.
Great musicians out of Nashville. The next band will be a Steely Dan Chicago tribute band called 12 Against Nature. And the lead singer for that band is a gentleman named Scott Sheriff, and he is the keyboard player for Carrie Underwood.
Mm-hmm.
So it's always great to see him and come down to Tullahoma. And they will play up until the 9 o'clock hour, which we'll have the Tullahoma Kiwanis will also be doing their Pledge of Allegiance and introducing the Volunteer of the Year Award. But we just want to, it's going to be such a great event. The fireworks are put on by a world-class fireworks company called Pyro Shows, and they do fireworks in New York City, the Washington, D.C. Mall,
mm-hmm.
and international. So you will not be disappointed. And seriously, we are adding more fireworks this year, too. So you're going to see more of the close-up fireworks, more of the taller fireworks,
mm-hmm.
more music. And then new this year, after the fireworks show, we're going to have a Tom Petty tribute band called Wildflowers, which will run up to 11. So I think the young people will enjoy staying out a little later, maybe some of the families that go on home after the fireworks. And then there'll be something there for people to stay out and enjoy the night. And it's going to be great. I've looked at the extended forecast. You know, it may be a little warm, but when the sun starts to set, the weather's going to be perfect. There's going to be food trucks there. Of course, we're going to have Miller Lite, Budweiser, Southern Community Bank's going to be there. We've got another host of sponsors. This is a community event, and our businesses that have sponsored us have been so generous, and we've got a whole host. We've got about 50 sponsors this year for this event. Some of the other sponsors I do want to mention would be like Jack Daniels, Russell Barnett, People's Finance, Coca-Cola, Tri-County, Citizens Tri-County Bank, NAS, Jacobs, and this year too we're also working on a craft brewer's beer tent, so
mm-hmm.
that's
going to
be another new thing. We've got all kinds of different vendors from 122 West that's going to be out there, where Piggy's Place, we're going to have hamburgers, hot dogs, cotton candy, all kinds of things for the kids. Speaking of kids, we got something for you at the kids' zone.
Okay.
We got a train rides.
Oh, yeah.
We've got a slip and slide,
yeah.
a water slide. We've got an exotic animal petting zoo.
Uh-huh.
So they've got camels and turtles. I think they've got a porcupine.
Can you pet turtles?
Well, this is a tortoise.
Yeah.
And I think it's about 70 years old. It's one of those big jobs.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not one of the little turtles.
Right.
Although we ought to have some of those little turtles out
yeah.
there. Give away for prizes and stuff like that. So there's going to be something for the entire family to enjoy, and we want to invite the community out. This is a totally free event. I mean, can you imagine?
It's hard to imagine.
Again, it's
I'm sure thanks in part to some of these sponsors you just mentioned.
Yes, that's exactly right. And again, it's really a great community event for the region. And again, it's because of the support of the sponsors that we're able to put on this event, which is really a tradition here in Southern Middle Tennessee. Been going on since 1968, which is a long time.
1968 is that
49 years.
49 years. That's
yeah.
that's hard to believe.
Yes.
Did you tell me that two of your beer sponsors went in business or something?
Yeah, I was doing a little research on those sponsors, and they both were founded in 1958.
Uh-huh.
I thought that was very interesting.
That is. So that's Cherokee and L&H.
That's right.
Yeah.
So the Miller Lite and Budweiser sponsors.
Right.
That's exactly right.
Right.
So they were in existence 10 years before the show. And so we want to encourage people to bring blankets and lawn chairs and head over to Grider Stadium. And the food vendors will be inside of Grider Stadium.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where we're encouraging everyone to sort of set up and find a great spot to watch the fireworks. Again, the main stage is going to be center field. And then what's great about being over in Grider Stadium is you can hear.
Right.
You can hear the music. You can hear the simulcast of the fireworks. But also we have close-up fireworks, which will be right behind the outfield wall. Mm-hmm. So if you happen to be somewhere else in the vicinity, you're not going to get the full effect.
Right.
So come on down. It's free. And have a great time. We're really just encouraging people to park at Northgate Mall. There's going to be a free shuttle that be able to drop you right at the park, because parking is going to be kind of a premium. Mm-hmm. And so we do encourage people, if you come over and the parking lots are full, just head on over to Northgate Mall, and that shouldn't be a problem at all.
And if you live anywhere around there, it'd be good to walk, because, you know, the fitness thing that the city of Tullahoma has going on all the time.
Yeah, you can
really
always
for you.
Walk or ride your bike.
Yeah.
And the businesses in the surrounding area there have given us permission to allow people to park, but they do ask that you don't park on their landscaping and you don't park on their grass.
Right.
So if you do come over, please stay on the pavement to park.
Right.
Don't be driving over the bushes and things.
Looks like you guys, or seems like you guys have really went all out. How do you get these entertainment, the bands and stuff? I mean, you have an agent or something?
Well, as I had mentioned, it's a community event, and it takes the entire community to get this on. But behind the scenes, there's a lot of work going on from the Tullahoma Parks and Recreation.
Mm-hmm.
And so they've just done a tremendous job. And they have a lot of connections with the bands in Nashville. And as you know, they do the concerts in the park in the fall and the spring. And so Kirk Lick has just been able to dial them up when we need them. And then as you get to know the different musicians, they kind of turn you on to other bands as well.
Sure.
So, yeah.
Okay. All right. That's coming up on July 3rd.
Don't miss
3rd.
It. July
yeah,
3rd.
Absolutely.
The gates open at 3.
Yeah.
We'll see you there.
Exactly. And Winston will be there as well. He's maybe sitting in with one of the bands. We're not sure. He knows how to do that, too.
Yeah, but I'm not going to do that this time. I'll be too busy trying to get everybody set up. And if people want more details, they can always go over to tullahomatn.gov/fireworks.
Okay. All right. One of the big, big events in Tullahoma, folks. Don't miss it. July 3rd. I assume that's
Monday.
Oh, it's Monday. Okay. All right. Monday, July 3rd.
Yes, sir.
All right. Winston, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Always very informative, and do such a great job as community coordinator. We're very fortunate to have you.
Thank you very much.
All right. Folks, we'll be right back with more Living right after this.
It's time for every family and business in Tullahoma to go green and recycle. Tullahoma Public Works makes it simple and easy to recycle. Just place your recyclable materials, paper, plastic, aluminum, and cardboard, beside your garbage container on the same day your garbage is picked up. Your recycled materials don't have to be in a fancy container. Recycling is not only the right thing to do, it makes sense. Recycling pays. Paying to bury our garbage costs each of us. Please do your part. Let's go green, Tullahoma, and recycle.
Hi, I'm Cindy.
And I'm Jacob. I'm the Rooster.
And I'm the Red Mate. And we would like to welcome you to
Roosterware.
Yes, Roosterware is a cottage industry producing accessories for men, women, children, babies, and pets. All items are hand-cut and sewn locally. Roosterware specializes in bow ties, pocket squares, scarves, cufflinks, neckties, and aprons of all sizes for all ages. Baby products include onesies, diaper covers, bibs, and burp pads. All bow ties, tie-it-yourself or pre-tied, come with an adjustable neckband. All products can be made with a material of your choice, as special orders are available upon request. Don't be standing back looking at fashion. Create your own with Roosterware.
Come visit us at
roosterandredmaiden.com
to find our handcrafted designs for
the cock of the walk.
This is an American Red Cross blood donation alert. The Red Cross is experiencing a severe winter blood shortage. There is an emergency need for blood and platelet donors to give now and help save hospital patient lives. Donations are critically needed so that patients can continue to receive the life-saving treatments they need. Resolve to make a difference and help save lives by giving blood or platelets now. Use the blood donor app, visit redcrossblood.org, or call 1-800-RED-CROSS to make an appointment.
Get your news first, fast, and free with your newsletter on 6 every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday nights at 6, 8, and 10 p.m. Local weather, sports, community calendar events, and a comprehensive look at the latest news stories and newsmakers as only a video news broadcast can do. Get it first, fast, and free with Newsleader on Channel 6, your local information network.
Talking history about this and that. It's Conversations with John and Pat, with John and Pat, with John and Pat.
Hello, everyone. I'm John Rickman.
And this is Pat Welch, and we're here today, John, for segment 54 of the Conversation with John and Pat. It's been pointed out by production that we now have over a year's worth of shows. In fact, this will be 2 weeks past a year, 52 weeks in a year, John.
This song I'm going to sing is based off of a Bible verse, 1 Thessalonians 4:16. And it was written by Mr. Black back in 1893 when the roll is called up yonder.
But whoa. The song was written by Mr. Black. The verse was been written by the Apostle Paul.
Well, I'm not going to argue with that. But it wasn't written just the way, but it transcends, the message comes through the chorus.
No, it's...
I'll have to read and make sure I'm correct on that. When the trumpet of the Lord shall call and time will be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the saved of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Let us labor for the Master from the dawn till setting sun. Let us think of all His wondrous love and care. And when all of life is over and our work on here is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. That's a good old song.
That is a good song.
Been around a long time.
A long time.
Since 1893, but you said, you know, the New Testament does. Yeah, it was first.
Correct.
I understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
We're talking about the first Little League state championship team, and that occurred 1984.
Was it two or four? Four. 84.
84.
Yeah.
I've got an article here, and we'll mention boys on that team in the front first row. Temple Bowling, Wayne Bird, Danny Riddle, Stacy Smith, Tracy Smith, Todd Branch, Patrick Cushman. Back row, Coach Jackie Revis, Chris Rickman, Sean Elrod, Vondell Hickerson, Gary Phillips, Craig Revis, Ted Farrell, Clyde Petty, and manager Charles Riddle. Great team. They went on to the Southeastern Conference play, I believe. It was in Florida, St. Petersburg,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
They were a great team. Jackie Revis is, of course, a great coach. And you and I can do his voice pretty good, Kate, with Pat,
when we really concentrate.
Yeah. And Pat, he's a great Christian man. Good man. So fine. And has a lot to do with your FCA here.
Though he lives in Murfreesboro in Florida now, any time that Fellowship of Christian Athletes has an event, and we had a fundraiser, I guess 3 weeks ago now, he blew in there like a Tasmanian devil and emptied his pockets, I can tell you that.
One person I'd like to make reference to, and Pat and I will talk about him a little bit, is Charles Riddle over there on the right, the gentleman, a little taller than Jackie, and he is absolutely a gentleman. His wife passed away, and then Ann Danewood's husband passed away, and Charles and Ann married.
You would have known Ann because Ann taught at East.
Yes.
She was a great lady.
But something about Charles Riddle that some of you may know and may not know, that he had four sons. And Danny, third from the left on the front row, is his son, Danny, number 11. And but he had four sons at one time, and there was a tragic automobile accident in Tullahoma where he had three sons killed. Those mm-hmm. three sons. Danny was the only
They were parked or stopped at a stoplight, and somebody came about 70 or 80 miles an hour from behind and hit them without braking and killed them. Horrible tragedy. In fact, when they went out, Danny was planning on going with him, and right at the last minute decided not to go, or he would have lost all of his sons.
I guess what we'll talk about here is how a man keeps going with his faith no matter what.
Yeah, we can. He and Ann, I went to church with, and Charles is a quiet, real steady kind of guy, and I taught and still teach high school Sunday school for a while. And I had a lesson coming up, and the guide wanted me to find somebody in the church that had faced a lot of tough situations but as an influence to your students, had not overcome it, but been able to live with it, and has faith and strengthened him during those times. And so I thought about Charles. So I called him up, and he seemed fine about it, you know. Said, "Well, we need to have you there at 10:30." Charles, he said, "I'll be there." And they said, "This is the first time I have done this, but I believe I can do it." So next Sunday, 10:30 came, and it wasn't any Charles. And about 10 more minutes later, there wasn't any Charles. So I called the house, and Ann answered the phone, and she knew what was going on, of course, immediately. And she said, "Pat, he won't be able to come." And I said, I'm so sorry." And she said, "Well, he left, but he got about halfway there and was just overcome with emotion and had to come back." But I told my class, most of which this class normally meets between two services, and I go to early service, but most of the class, being teenagers, goes to second service, and Charles and Ann did too. And I told my class, I said, "He can't make it, but I'll tell you as a living testimony to this man's faith, I bet he'll be there in about 20 more minutes." And sure enough, he came in there, and then it made a dent on my students, and he never had to say a word. Yeah. Great, great guy, great family, great, great people.
What more can you say
after
a story like that?
Yeah.
And I hope someone that sees this maybe will pass this on to Ann and Charles.
Yeah. Let them know. They're living in Nashville now, I believe. In fact, I have not seen them in 4 or 5 years, and I this is going to make me try to seek them out and check back with them. Yeah.
That's good. That's segment 54, Pat.
54 is a somber one, but one that we hope strengthens people. And if management will let us be back, we're coming back for 55. Thank you.
Talking history about this and that. It's Conversations with John and Pat. With John and Pat. With John and Pat.
So you've been meaning to do something healthy, commune with nature, get outdoors and meet new people. We have the perfect solution. Come hike with us. You can find a Tennessee Trails Association chapter near you, including Clarksville, Columbia Franklin, Highland Rim, Jackson, Knoxville, Oak Ridge, Memphis, Murfreesboro, Nashville, Plateau at Crossville, and Upper Cumberland. We're on the web at TennesseeTrails.org. It's fun, it's stress-free, and it's good for you. See you on the trails.
Tired of paying for monthly telephone service, expensive long-distance bills, and all those crazy taxes? Are you sick of spending money on telephone equipment, maintenance contracts, and service calls, all for a phone system that shackles you to 100-year-old technology and your desk? Stop it. It's time to ship your phone system to the cloud. What can the cloud do for you? Bring together remote offices, workers, and employees in the field. Make sure that you'll never miss calls by delivering them to multiple devices. Modernize faxing by allowing multiple faxes to be sent and received at once and delivered to email. Get your voicemail messages instantly through email too. And take advantage of an endless supply of customizable features. Host My Calls can deliver the cloud. All of this technology with low upfront costs and not one penny in capital expense. It's time for a phone solution you'll truly love from Host My Calls. Call the number below.
Get your news first, fast, and free with your news leader on 6 every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday nights at 6, 8, and 10 p.m. Local weather, sports, community calendar events, and a comprehensive look at the latest news stories and newsmakers as only a video news broadcast can do. Get it first, fast, and free with News Leader on Channel 6, your local information network.
Welcome back. I'm so glad I have Jackie Duncan on the show today, one of my favorite poets in all this world. And
thank
you're not
you.
Talking poetry today, are you?
No, not
no.
today.
We're talking about something else. There's some really nice events coming up. So what should we do first?
Got some real nice events. This one, a friend of mine is participating in this, Synobia McGee. This is a Chicago Mass Choir will be in Murfreesboro on the 22nd of July at 6 p.m. You can get at Mount Zion Baptist Church here in Tullahoma.
Oh, okay. And is this a gospel?
It's a gospel
basically
singing,
gospel.
Yes.
And Chicago Synobia Mass Choir. McGee, we used to call Snoopy long time ago.
I call her Reverend Snoopy now.
Reverend Scoopy.
Yes, yeah, Reverend
she
Snoopy.
She is beautiful and she is talented.
She is very
I guarantee
talented.
You.
And she does have a single out on CD Baby, I believe, right now.
Oh, wonderful.
Sure is,
I'd like to hear it.
Yeah.
All right, the tickets
beautiful.
Are only $10 in advance,
right.
$20 at the door, so I would suggest you get them in advance. And for ticket information, here's the number. Maybe y'all can put this up in the back. 615-653-1167. I mean, advance ticket seems the way to go here.
It does. It
yeah.
really does.
And it looks like a huge choir. There's got to be
it is.
60, 70 people.
Oh, they... You know, I don't know, and I don't know if this is the traveling choir, but it might be the same choir. You know, sometimes you might have a traveling choir that's less numbered, but this choir has been around for a long time, and it's a great choir.
And,
so.
And it's at a church in Murfreesboro.
It is Southeast Baptist Church, 708 Minerva Drive in Murfreesboro, and this is July 22nd at 6 p.m. on a Saturday.
On a Saturday, so you get there before dark, and it maybe. Last couple 3 hours and you're getting home.
There you go.
Maybe.
And this might be the same. I've got about 3 family reunions coming up in July.
Yeah.
So and one of them's going to be in Murfreesboro. So I don't know if this is the same weekend. I think this might be the weekend before that. But
well,
I'm just thinking I could go to that and come
well,
right.
You can do it all. Yeah.
Yeah, I can do it all. I think
well, the
so.
Price is certainly right.
It and, is. It really is.
This yeah. is. 6 o'clock, I think, is a good time for an event.
It is.
I often wonder why we start things later, because you can go to the event and you can go to dinner.
There you go.
And that's kind of a nice idea.
Yes.
But this is going to be a wonderful concert. Southeast Baptist Church. I don't really personally know where Minerva Drive is. But
I got no idea either.
Since you can get information from this phone number, I think that's the best way to go. And they probably have a website, but yeah. I don't see it right here.
Well, you know, it's so easy to plug in a name on the internet now.
And you can find anything you want.
You can find anything. It'll give you the instructions how to get there, and it'll take you there if you really
want
to.
Show you a picture of their house.
Well, they got a car that'll drive you there. You know, it'll drive you itself before long, I think. So that is the next event pretty much that's in order. And after that, well, I've got a school reunion coming up, Davidson Academy, and that's one of the real reasons I'm here today.
How many years has Davidson Academy been open? Do you remember the first year?
The first year
you don't necessarily remember, but do you know the date?
I believe it was 1898. I believe so. And the information is out on the website. The website is DavidsonAcademyAlumni.org.
Davidson Academy Alumni.
And if you want to put the www there, you know.
But either way, you can get it.
You can get it without that
anymore. You
can anymore,
actually just put Davidson Academy, just put Tullahoma, Tennessee, and you'll get it.
Well, there you go. Yeah.
As long as you have the Tennessee.
There was a big problem with just getting on the internet with the Davidson Academy, because there's one in Nashville also.
And
a lot of times that would come up. Just put in Davidson Academy Tullahoma and you should go right to the website. But you can register online for this.
Oh,
you
know, good.
Yeah, you can register for the reunion online. Just go out there and put it, type in your information. And really anybody locally, and I encourage this, anybody locally, just call Luvenia Hayes or me.
Oh, she knows it all, doesn't she?
Yeah, 2962-455-2962 will get Luvenia Hayes. She'll register you right over the phone.
Oh, wonderful.
Then you
and y'all do this every other year, don't you?
Every other year, yes.
And so it's a big event.
It's a big event, and you know, they're not making any Davidson Academy students anymore.
No, they're not.
But now we're Davidson Academy students and friends, former students and friends and family. You know, so we invite friends to come that we, you know, we got loved ones all over. We got friends everywhere. So last time we had like 200 people.
That's marvelous.
And we went totally electronic last time. We went total internet.
Now, what's the date on that?
This is August the 4th through the 6th.
So it's a
it's coming
weekend.
Up very soon, it's the first. It's always the first full weekend in August. The first Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. That's the formula. So.
So that brings people in to get hotels and eat in the restaurants.
It does. It does.
And so the jazz night. That's the reunion, right?
No.
No, that's
no,
a whole different thing.
This is a whole different ball
game.
All right,
let me get my dates straight.
Oh, we've got a great band for the reunion also. And reunion, we have our dinner at the Manchester Coffee County Conference Center.
Which is a wonderful
place.
Wonderful place. And the food is excellent.
It is.
They have a good chef.
Uh-huh. We've had that there for the last bunch of years, ever since they've pretty much been open, I think. But anyway, that's the Davidson Academy School Reunion, and we encourage everybody, especially the local ones, to go ahead and register, get your registration in.
And it's $40. And
$40 per person for 3 days.
That's amazing.
It's amazing, and we try our very best to hold costs down, and we've done it real good.
Well, so we got a great team. $40 include dinner,
a band,
and
a weekend of just activities at the CD Stamps Community Center. We have food there. That Friday night, we have food there. That Saturday morning.
So this must bring a lot of people in from out of town.
It does. It does.
That helps the economy.
It helps the economy.
This area,
yes, yes, it does. And
that's
we have
wonderful.
People staying in Manchester and Tullahoma hotels, and like I said, it's a lot of money that comes into our communities because of this.
And the date on that is the weekend of August 4th.
Weekend of August the 4th. That Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Well, if you're going to have a reunion, that's a good way to do it.
It is.
Because if you want to have time to visit and time to talk about old times.
It is.
Do y'all have speakers and stuff, or do you?
We do. We have different events. Everything hasn't been finalized as far as speakers or anything like that go. But we do, and we have an afternoon in the park down at the Jefferson Street Park, and we invite. We've got several vendors that have been coming for the last several years that actually set up and fundraisers for their church. Fish fry. We've got quite a few people already that do that.
People that go out and catch all the fish.
No, they don't go out and catch them. Thank goodness, I don't think.
My brother-in-law used to do that for his school. He was a principal, he would catch fish and do a fish fry. Well, and then you have this other event coming up.
Okay, and then. Now, that's for the Davidson Academy School Reunion. Now, I also represent the Tennessee State University Alumni Association, which I'm vice president for the local chapter here.
Yeah, and we are running out of time.
Okay.
You may have to come back and talk about this again, because this is in
August 18th, Friday, August 18th, and it's going to be right here in this building.
Yeah.
Tickets are $25. Night with the Hamilton Brothers, jazz night with the Hamilton Brothers.
So
we're going to have a great night.
Jackie, I wish we had more time, but come back and we'll talk about it again. Thanks for coming.
Yes, thank you.
We'll be back.
At the time, maybe you were just building a bridge, a business, or a community. Maybe you were simply working for a home or a better tomorrow. At the time, you served out of duty and love of country. But in that time, we see a legacy created, an American dream lived. The rehab team at Life Care Center of Tullahoma is ready to help you live well.
There's no place like home.
Getting home safely is just a click away. And choosing the right seat for your little one's age and size will take you down the road to safer travels.
How can I ever thank you enough?
Visit safercar.gov/the right seat.
I'm meteorologist Leland Statham from the News Channel 5 Weather Center. Look to Jim Fuller and crew for local news night here on Channel 6.
All right, folks, we've had a great show today. We're running short on time for the closing, so Peggy.
He's going to say goodbye.
Yeah, welcome back. Glad you got back safe from your trip. Folks, thanks a whole lot for watching. Tell your friends about us. You can go to www.channel6thelink.com. It's our on-demand free website. Watch all our shows. See you next time. Visit our sponsors and buy something.